Hello, and welcome to our service of light this All Souls' Tide. We hope that this will be a service where you can pause and have chance to reflect and to give thanks for those who have died recently, but also to pause and reflect and stand with all those across the world who are struggling with COVID-19 and have died of COVID-19. Some of you may have had chance to download our order of service. If you have, then please do follow it as much or as little as you wish. If you haven't, that's fine. Just be still and rest and join in with those parts that you feel comfortable with. I would encourage you, if you can, to have a candle that either you light as I light the candles behind me, or that you light at the end of the service so you can continue to ponder, to pray, to give thanks, and to reflect. So, grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you as we gather in the light of Christ shines in the midst of our uncertainty and our fear. So I light the candles. I light a candle for all people. We light a candle to bring hope out of darkness. I light a candle for all creation. We light a candle to bring joy out of chaos. I light a candle to bring a love. And I'm now going to light the Easter candle as a way of marking and remembering more than the million people who have died across the world during this ongoing pandemic. And as we gaze on those candles, we pray. We thank you for your sustaining love. We remember those who we love but see no longer. We acknowledge all those who have died unnoticed and unremarked. We ask that you keep us all under the shadow of your mercy in this time of ongoing uncertainty. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful. Lift up all who are brought low. Empower and embolden all your people to live out their calling as people of faith, that we may all rejoice in your saving love for us, knowing that nothing can separate us from that love in Christ Jesus our Lord. We're now going to listen to Catherine Jenkins sing the prayer.
With your grace, to a place where we'll be. us with your grace. Give us faith so we'll be saved. Soñamos mundos sin violencia, un mundo
as we continue to ponder and to reflect, we say together, God of all life and of what comes beyond the life we know, we come to you in our need. We come in our brokenness. We come with our gratitude. We come with our loose ends that we haven't been able to tie up. We do not know what has led us here, but we know that you have promised never to turn us away. Be with us in our uncertainty. Be with us in our grief. And hear our prayers. Amen. Psalm 42. As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and behold the face of God? My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me continually, "Where is your God?" These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I went with the throng and led them in procession to the house of God with glad shouts and songs of thanksgiving, a multitude keeping festival. Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. My soul is cast down within me, therefore I remember you from the land of Jordan and from Hermon, from Mount Mizar. Deep calls the deep at the thunder of your cataracts, all your waves and your billows have gone over me. By day the Lord commands his steadfast love, and at night his song is with me. A prayer to the God of my life. I say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why must I walk about mournfully because the enemy oppresses me? As with a deadly wound in my body, my adversaries taunt me, while they say to me continually, where is your God? Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. Your word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. I think Psalm 42 captures so profoundly those overwhelming feelings of uncertainty and fear, those overwhelming feelings of being abandoned, particularly when we are grieving. And yet in the midst of all his despair, he clings to God. And that is all that we can do some of the time when we are feeling overwhelmed. For many people, the following reflection is really helpful. It's the footprints in the sand, and it reminds us that even in the worst of times, even in the midst of overwhelming suffering and pain, God is with us, even when we can't recognize it for ourselves. One night I dreamed a dream. As I was walking along the beach with my Lord, across the dark sky flashed scenes from my life. For each scene I noticed two sets of footprints in the sand, one belonging to me and one to my Lord. After the last scene of my life flashed before me, I looked back at the footprints in the sand. I noticed that at many times along the path of my life, especially at the lowest and saddest times, there was only one set of footprints. This really troubled me, so I asked the Lord about it. Lord, you said, once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I noticed that during the saddest and most troublesome times of my life, there was only one set of footprints. I don't understand why, when I needed you the most, you would leave me. He whispered, my precious child, I love you and will never leave you. Never, ever, during your trials and testings. When you saw only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you. We're now going to watch a reenactment of John's Gospel where Jesus weeps at the tomb of his friend Lazarus, who has died. It's a very profound passage, but let's watch it and ponder and reflect.
On his arrival, Jesus found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was less than 2 miles from Jerusalem, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them in the loss of their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went out to meet him. But Mary stayed at home. Lord, Martha said to Jesus, if you had been here, my brother would not have died, but I know that even now God will give you whatever you ask. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha answered, I know he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, Lord, she replied. I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, who has come into the world. After she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary aside. The teacher is here, she said, and is asking for you. When Mary heard this, she got up quickly and went to him. Now Jesus had not yet entered the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews who had been with Mary in the house comforting her noticed how quickly she got up and went out, they followed her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn there. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. "Where have you laid him?" he asked. "Come and see, Lord," they replied. Jesus wept. Then the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. "Take away the stone," he said. "But Lord," said Martha, the sister of the dead man, "by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there 4 days." Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, Jesus called out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth round his face. Jesus said to them, "Take off the grave clothes and let him go."
I think watching that reenactment brings home the myriad of different emotions that always affect us when someone we are close to dies. Anger. Anger that they died. Perhaps anger that there's a sense that they didn't get the care they needed, or anger with them for leaving us alone, abandoning us, leaving such a huge gap in our lives. And then there's the confusion, the bewilderment, the lack of clarity about what we should do, what we should be, how we should act, and just that lost sense of certainty. No longer are we sure of who we are, or that life is what we thought it was. Our lives have been literally turned upside down. And then that deep, deep sadness. The sadness that you can't describe to anybody else, that consumes the whole of your being, that is right in the depths of your soul. And you long. You long for what is going on to stop, and for that miracle to happen. And of course, in the scriptures, Jesus does perform that miracle, and Lazarus is raised from the dead. And I think there are many questions that this passage poses to us about, well, why doesn't that happen today? Why can't I see that person I long to see again? And we can't answer that question. And we don't know why Jesus waited 4 days before he went to the tomb. And that's part of the realism of this story, that there are so many unanswered questions Just as there are always so many unanswered questions when someone we care about dies. Yes, of course, often they are people who have died after a long and fulfilled life. But even then, there are still those moments when you wonder why. Why now? Why am I left with that hole in my life? But equally, there are times when people die too early, when children die, when people die in their 20s and 30s, as we are seeing at the moment with this pandemic, when people die before their time, when people die of unnatural causes, they're killed in a car accident, or they take their own life. Then that bewilderment and that pain and that uncertainty and those questions continue long time into the future and are often painful and impossible to answer. Just as in this passage, it is impossible to know the mind of Jesus as he waited and then as he wept. And then as he called Lazarus out of the tomb. But what we do know and what we can be confident of is that hope that we have because Jesus died for us. That hope that we have that this is not the end. The hope that we have of life eternal. Hope beyond this world. And I love that phrase that we heard read in Psalm 42. Deep calls to deep. And for me, that in a sense is part of what this eternal hope is about. It's beyond our words and it's beyond our understanding. But there's that sense of our deep parts of us calling to the deep parts of God. And in that moment of call, we find the peace that we need to continue to take the next step on our own journeys and entrust those we love and care for to God. So as we continue to ponder, let's pause and listen to another piece of music.
Thank you.
So, let us declare our faith. We believe in God, who brought forth light from chaos and darkness. We believe in Jesus, who faced the darkness of the grave and rose from death to life and glory. We believe in the Holy Spirit, who walks with us in darkness and light. We believe that we are surrounded always by a great company of saints and angels. We believe that we are called to share and proclaim the justice and wonder of God. So, let us pray to God, who alone makes us dwell in safety. We pray for those who are guiding our nation at this time and shaping national policies, that they may make wise decisions. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For doctors and nurses and medical researchers, that through their skill and insights, all would be cared for with compassion and wisdom. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For the vulnerable and the fearful, for the gravely ill and the dying, that they would know your comfort and peace. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We give thanks for those we remember, for those who lit our lives with joy, for those who touched us with tenderness, for those whose loss fills us with longing. We give thanks in glad remembrance. And as we remember and we give thanks, we join together in saying the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Come, bless us, God. Bless us with tears and laughter. Bless us with love. Come, bless us, Jesus. Bless us with hope and healing. Bless us with love. Come, bless us, Holy Spirit. Bless us with creativity and wisdom. Bless us with love. Amen.